a loud amen.
Amen.
The amen of somebody is grateful that the Lord has preserved you to this day. Let me hear you shout a loud
amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Let's rise to our feet now. So raise up our two hands and sing this song loud and clear. To the King of Kings and to the Lord of Lords. The one who has brought us to this very last Sunday service of this year.
Who
has preserved us from January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, and unto this last Sunday of the month. Thank you, Jesus. As many as are grateful to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, let the voice of your praises be the loudest there. Thank you, Jesus. Be thou exalted, O Lord above. Be thou exalted, O Lord above.
Let the glory be
on the earth. Let your glory be above on the earth.
Sing it loud and clear.
Be thou exalted, O Lord, above the heavens. Be thou exalted, O Lord, above the heavens.
Hallelujah.
Let your glory be above all the earth.
Hallelujah.
Let your glory be above all the earth.
Jehovah is your name.
Jehovah is your name.
Hallelujah,
mighty warrior, great in battle, Jehovah is your name.
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 Hallelujah,
mighty warrior, great in battle, Jehovah is your name.
Ibukalaba
Jesu lamuwe.
Oyelembeba.
Hallelujah.
Can you shout this loud and clear? Every waster, assigned against my life, be wasted in the name of Jesus. Yes. thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. This is number two. Prayed very well. Arrows that entered into my life in the night. Somebody needs to shout that prayer loud and clear. Backfire! In the name of Jesus. Command the night arrows of backfire. In Jesus' name we pray. This third prayer we're going to pray. Within the next 48 hours of praying this prayer, the Lord will do something unforgettable in many lives. Where is the Lord God of Elijah?
Allah,
give me a miracle that will move me forward. In the name of Jesus, a miracle that will move me forward. Something is going on over there.
Oh, consider that we are.
In Jesus' name we pray. Angels of war, arise. Kill every enemy of my progress. In the name of Jesus. That is number four prayer. Pray it very well. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Wherever the enemy has stopped me this year, can you shout it loud? I get out now. In the name of Jesus. Wherever the enemy has stopped me this year, I get out now. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Two more prayers. Powers assigned to make my enemies laugh at me. You are a liar. In the name of Jesus. Yes. Jesus' name we pray. Can you shout this louder than anyone here? And don't keep quiet until I stop you. Pass! Introducing delay to my breakthrough. Can I hear the sister saying it? The sisters are not shouting it well. Can I hear the brothers saying the same thing? Before I leave this place, in the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you for today. Accept our thanks in the name of Jesus. Father, we are gathered here to sing praises to your holy name. And to encourage ourselves in the singing of hymns. Father, lay your hands upon us. Anoint us by your power. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's have a seat for a few minutes. God bless you. As we open our Bibles once again to the book of Numbers, chapter 11, verse 29. Every member a prophet. Every member a prophet. Numbers 11:29 points us loud and clear to the heart cry of Moses, the servant of God, which is still the same heart cry today. And I'm praying for all who are gathered there listening to me. And as we are moving into this next year, may you become a prophet of the Most High God. May you stop seeing things after the flesh. May heaven open your eyes so that you can see. Numbers 11:29. And Moses said unto him, and fearest thou for my sake? Would God that all the lost people were prophets? And that the Lord would put his spirit upon them? Moses said, how I wish everybody would be a prophet. And that the spirit of God is on upon their lives. He wants everybody to be a prophet. And like I've been telling you since we started teaching this series, God said, touch not my anointed. Do my prophets no harm. And anytime somebody tries to touch his prophets in scripture, the reaction of heaven is very violent. Do you want the reaction of heaven to be violent against those who want to harm you? Become a prophet. If there is any need of the hour, it's for everyone to develop themselves. Spiritually. It's for everyone to become a Bible student. A prophet. With that, you can stand any storm. With that, you don't put your life on a man. The Bible says, woe unto him that putteth his trust in man, whose breath is in his nostrils. Woe unto that person. The Bible issues a curse on those who put their lives on man. No matter how anointed a prophet is, a pastor is, he's still a man. They say, give a man a fish. You have given him a meal. But teach him to fish. You fed him for life. It is the desire of God. As MFM begins to talk about rearrange for revival, every member becomes a prophet. So wherever you are, nobody can see black and call it white for you. Nobody can see fake and call it truth for you. But like everything in the spirit realm, there is a price to pay. A price to pay. A price to pay.
Oh, no, continue, no.
It is the area of price to pay that is a problem. Many just want to come to church and pick and choose which one they want to follow in the words of God. They pick the one that is convenient for them instead of what is commanded. There is a difference between what is convenient for you and what is commanded. You should become a prophet of the Most High. So that you stop consulting people all over the place. You go to people that even you are more anointed than, say, Baba, pray for me. Because you didn't develop yourself.
You
put your head under bondage. The pastor is not your God. Your God is the Almighty God. The Almighty God. This is a very serious matter. And I want you to understand this very, very well. Once upon a time, a couple used to fight a lot. And during the fighting, the man is an elder in church. The woman too is a woman leader somewhere.
He's fighting.
And during the fight, this man always beats up the woman. The woman will be crying and trying to defend the blows landing on her head. Then one day, the woman decided to fight back a little bit. So as the man was raining blows on her head, the woman endured the blow. She just put one blow onto the chest of the man. And to her amazement, the man fell down flat. She now sat down on him and pounded his head very well with blows. That day ended. Another time they started to quarrel again. The fight started. The man was raining blood on her. She relaxed, surviving that those blows. Put the single blow again onto the man's chest. The man landed on the floor. Again, she sat on him and pounded it. So this was how power changed hands. So instead of the woman being beaten up, the woman is not beating up the man. It was at that level the man now wanted to go and report to the pastor that the wife was beating him. So he went to the pastor's house. But a few meters to the pastor's house, he saw the pastor and his wife fighting. He stood and watched them. And he shook his head. He said, I will go and solve my own problem. Pastor too is boxing here. I'm telling you this so that you be your own prophet. Don't put your destiny on the head of a man. The prophetic, the gift of prophecy, the gift of seeing into the spiritual realm, is not the gift for pastors alone. It's not the gift for ministers alone. Before you can get there, If you pay the price, every member a prophet. Who is a prophet? A prophet is a man who has insight into the will and purposes of God. He knows it. Who is a prophet? A prophet is an oracle of God. Who is a prophet? A prophet is a divine mouthpiece. A man or woman with his or her head in heaven. The prophetic ministry, beloved, is a ministry of seeing in the spirit. Seeing beyond these eyes of the spirit. If a prophet of
Jehovah,
you will receive visions, dreams, from the Lord. It is important that you develop yourself to that level where you can be seen in the spirit.
You
can be seen in the spirit. I know many years ago when I taught this topic somewhere, there was a man who was selling tires. He had the best
car.
But as a customer beside another trader beside him, who only sells second hand tires and all those bad, weak tires. He very well. All of a sudden, he said that people custom to his store. How much is this? I'm coming. They go into the second shop. He will see them carrying out tires. Sometimes they just come. Stay at his shop. Go into the second one. He did not understand. This man is selling, he's not a Christian. He's a believer. For 3 months,
he
sold one tire. But it was fortunate to be in the place where I was teaching this. And he prayed the prayers of open eyes. The prayers of open my eyes. Oh Lord. Hallelujah. Open my eyes.
Hallelujah.
Oh Lord. He prayed those prayers. And he kept praying. He prayed again when he got home at night. All of his father, God opened his eyes. He saw a big hole. Somebody dug at the front of his shop. And he saw a white handkerchief inside the hole. He did not understand. What is this? But anyway, he took a crazy step. Next morning, he went to work with something to dig the ground. He started digging. People were laughing at him. Eventually, he came across this white thing. A white underwear. At the front of the shop. Took it out. Anointed it. Burnt it. That day, he did not sit down until all tires were sold. One person is going, another person is coming. Somebody is going, another person is going. While the traffic was going on in his place, some of those who bought tires in other places had to return the one they bought. So seeing in the spirit will certainly benefit your life. Elisha told Gehazi, Did I not go with you in the spirit?
Oju mi ko pa npo lo
when you went to collect something from Naaman.
Nipa to lo pa nkokon lowo Naaman.
When you see the spirit like that.
Nipa ba ri nkan ni pere.
Things that have gone behind you.
Awon nkan ti won se leyin re.
Is made clear to you.
Awa wa ni kara jagara ni wa
to re. Very very clear to you.
Wo bi yete.
I'm praying for somebody here this morning. And let your amen roar like fire and like thunder. By the power that divided the Red Sea. By the power that pulled down
Goliath.
By the power that slapped Aaron with worms. I decree and declare that everyone shall open your eyes in the name of Jesus. Receive the miracle of open hands. Receive the miracle of open hands in the name of Jesus. When we say somebody is seen in the spirit, it means you are having your spiritual eyes open. I'm happy with members who are beginning to understand this message. Like the woman who saw the evil bird flying about. Normally, she would not even have seen anything. It's a tragedy. When witchcraft birds are flying all over your room and you cannot see. It's when that spiritual eyes open, they are exposed. And she wanted to run away, but she said no. Because of this lecture she's been hearing. She was able to deal with that animal. So, seeing in the spirit, beloved, having your spiritual eyes open. May your spiritual eyes be open in the name of Jesus. Seeing in the spirit is having revelational dreams, visions, trances, expressions of visitations. That's what it means to see the spirit. Seeing in the spirit
is
to have spiritual sight. You see into the spirit realm. And when you now begin to see in the spirit, it may not start in a big way. Some it may start in a dream. Some it may start in a vision. Some it may start with things just flashing across their eyes. Some it could start with a picture just showing up before them. Some will see something when they close their eyes. When they open their eyes, they don't see it anymore. Some will open and close and they will still be seeing it. There are different categories of seeing in the spirit. But when you begin to see in the spirit, number one, you become a member of the company of the prophets.
Oh, the okan ninu awon omo ebe woli.
Two.
Ikeji.
Fear.
Eru.
Becomes an alien commodity in your life.
Adi ohun elo to won ninu aye re.
Because you can see into the spirit.
Nitori ko le ri nkan lo nipa ti emi.
Fear becomes an alien commodity in your life.
Eru. Adi oja ti o si aye re.
Three.
Iketa.
You no longer see men after the flesh alone. You see them for who they really are. Four. You will gain access to the secrets and mysteries of God. Then you understand what Amos is trying to say. He says, God does nothing unless he first reveals it to his servants, the prophets. He may ask them not to talk, but will reveal it to his servants, the prophets. Five. You have more confidence in God. Six. Your life becomes a divine phenomenon. The wonder how you know things. Seven. You become the people the Bible calls a seer. When you can see into the spirit realm. Eight. You become a voice that has recognition in heaven or in hell. Because you can see into the spirit realm what is going on. Nine. Seeing into the spirit makes you to become a champion of situations. Next. Seeing in the spirit makes you become a student in the school of revelation. And lastly, seeing in the spirit makes you to avoid walking into the enemy's trap. Walking to the enemy's trap. Somebody shared a very sad story with me this morning. The person was here on Christmas Day. On 25th. And she heard me saying, be careful where you eat, what you eat. And that day she had the opportunity to eat in places she just remembered and did not touch anything. But she had a relative who went to this party to eat. She got home. This person got home and the stomach began to get into trouble. Was becoming horrible. They rushed the person to the hospital. While they were still trying to see what to do at the hospital, he died there. They have taken the virtue through food, added it to their own. And the person is gone. The tragedy is that those who are doing this kind of thing, bewitching people through food, they may later get born again. Where they have wasted so many people. And the mystery of our faith, the Lord will accept it. Meanwhile, they have wasted life. So if you allow yourself to be used by as chewing stick by the enemy, that will be your fault. Seeing in the spirit will make you avoid walking to the enemy's trap. A brother was flying somewhere. His practice normally was that once he enters the plane and he sits down, he prays. He sat down, prayed. As he said, Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit this aircraft into your holy hands. All of a sudden, he saw a pool of blood. He continued the prayer. The blood was gushing again. So he just stood up, removed his briefcase from the place, and began to walk out. The hostess said, where are you going? I'm not traveling this place. So, but you're already inside. You can't leave now. I said, I have to leave. So you not get a refund of your ticket. Say, don't worry about refund. I'm leaving. Do you know? That plane crashed. Everybody died. What saved that fellow? Ability to see spirit. Lies to your feet now. And all eyes closed. This prayer I want you to pray. It's not a gentleman's prayer. It's a prayer to remove spiritual cataracts. It's a prayer to open your eyes into the spirit realm. It's a prayer that many have prayed. And they became champions. And I'm sure as you pray today, you become a champion as well. Can you shout this loud and clear? Holy Ghost! Is that the loudest you can shout it? Overshadow my eyes! In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. A louder amen. Stretch your two hands to me at the altar here. And let your amen roar like thunder. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. For all these hands stretched forward here, let them become the hands of blessing, the hands of glory, the hands of power, the hands of strength, the hands that will break the backbone of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, I bless you in the name of the Lord. Your going and your coming out shall be blessed. The spirit of the living God will overshadow you. The power of God will fill your life. From the top of the head to the sole of the feet. In the name of Jesus. And as this coming year approaches, any blessing you've lost in January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, and this December, repossess them in the name of Jesus. The God of 24 hours miracle, the God of 48 hours miracle, shall visit you by fire in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Glory be to your holy name. Before you go, I'd like you to shout this warfare prayer before we close. Don't say, well, I've prayed it before. Say, any power assigned to use me as a sacrifice. I bury you now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Before we share the grace lesson, the primary blue buses will be available at the following locations from 12 p.m. on 12 afternoon, midday on Tuesday 31st. I will bring members back immediately after the program. Oshio, the charity bus stop, Agege Women Development Center, Yanawood under the bridge, Obalende under the bridge, Ikorodu, Agri bus stop, Yaba Abbey Road, Mai 2 under the bridge. And MFM outside is for members of the youth church. Also, church buses will be available at the toll gate and Ojudu Baga. All select Jesha members and his referrals should find their way to Mile 2 or Charity Oshodi bus stop. Because we will not be available at a select bus stop due to construction going on along Apapa Oshodi Expressway. Let us share the grace and fellowship. Grace of our Lord Jesus. Love of God. And the speech fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow all the days of our life. We shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Seven miracle receiving. Hallelujah.